AD authentication is very important for most SQL Server professionals. In this episode, learn how to enable AD authentication easily on SQL Server 2019 in containers. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Amit, a program manager on the Azure SQL and SQL Server team. Amit, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit more about what you do?
Hi, Anna. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for inviting me here today. I'm really excited to be part of this show. And I'm working as a senior program manager for SQL Server team, currently working on SQL Server on Linux and containers.
Awesome. Great. We're excited to have you here. And we're actually going to be talking about just that, SQL Server and containers. And this is an exciting topic, something we've talked about, you know, a decent bit on the show. But today we're going to be talking about AD authentication and SQL Server containers, which is something I really don't know anything about. So I'm really looking forward to learning from you today, Amit. If, you know, and we can just go ahead and get started. Can you tell us a little bit more about AD auth in SQL containers and how easy or how difficult it is to set that up?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And that's the whole reason why I want to be part of this show, because I'd seen the earlier show where you worked or you did an earlier show with Anthony where you talked about SQL Server and containers and how it can be deployed. I just want to go ahead and expand on that specific episode, you know, this as the next one where we go ahead and configure AD authentication. Now, as you would know, Anna, AD authentication is one of the most asked feature for most of our enterprise customers when they're working with SQL Server, because it's one of the most strongest authentication mechanisms. So I'm here to talk about how you can actually enable AD authentication for SQL Server containers, which is running on Linux. And I also want to put myself to a challenge, which is I want my customers to be able to go ahead and configure AD authentication for SQL Server containers on Linux in less than 5 minutes. And that's what I'm going to talk about and show in this episode as well. So let me just get started with the presentation here. I hope all of us can see the screen, the presentation. Okay, let's see what is, how do we get started with AD authentication? Now, we've got a new tool out there, which is in preview stage today, which is called as the AD Util. And I'm just going to be talking about it. And I know the second question that you might have is, why are we talking about AD Util when we want to talk about AD authentication for SQL containers? And this is where AD Util is basically your friend to help you configure SQL Server AD authentication on SQL Server containers in less than 5 minutes. So let's first answer the first part of the question. What is AD Util? AD Util is a CLI-based utility that we have created to provide a seamless experience for AD configuration. And I would show you a demo of how seamless this is, because you don't have to move from Linux to a Windows machine to create users in Active Directory and then come back to your Linux machine to create key tabs. You can do all of that from your one single host, which is running Linux. So AD Util basically gives you that experience of, you know, from one machine, you can do end-to-end configuration. The second part that I want to talk about, it's actually designed as a series of subcommands and commands that you can input and create and manage your Active Directory. Now, the second part of the question that people might have is, why are we talking about it and what can I do with this utility? And this is where I want to talk about what this utility can be used for. This utility can be used to create a user, create an SPN, create key tabs, create organizational units, OUs that we call, and create groups all on Windows Active Directory from a Linux machine. So you can be logged into your Linux machine, and from there, you can go ahead, create users, SPNs, and key tabs, which is essentially the requirement for making a Linux service talk to an Active Directory over Kerberos. So that's what AD Util is going to do, and that's how AD Util comes in picture to help you configure Active Directory authentication. Now, let me talk to you about how can we set this all up. And the it's basically a simple five-step process that you need to follow. The first thing that you would want to do is install this Adutil tool on the Linux host machine where you would be running the SQL Server container. Or you could install Adutil to another machine which is already part of the Active Directory domain, but is not going to be the host that's going to run the container. So basically, you for you know going ahead and configuring SQL Active Directory authentication for SQL containers, you don't need the host to be part of the domain. You can have the host as not part of the domain and still run SQL Server container as part of a domain. And that's where the second step is actually optional, where you would, if you'd like, you can join your Linux host to the domain. If you don't, you don't have to really do it for SQL Server containers. The third step that we would have to do then is we create an Active Directory user for SQL Server and also create the SPNs that we all are probably familiar with, which is nothing but the service principal names using which Kerberos actually works. So in SQL Server and Linux, we basically support Kerberos authentication for enabling Active Directory authentication, and Kerberos authentication on both Open LDAP as well as SSSD is currently supported. And that's what we are doing here as well. So we create an AD user for SQL Server that is going to be used by SQL Server to talk to the Active Directory. And we also use the SPNs, which will be required for, you know, for the ticket exchange on the Kerberos. The third step that you kind of have to do is create the SQL Server service key tab. And this, again, is something that we're going to do with Adutil tool. And once we create the key tab, it basically has the entries of the user and the SPNs, which binds the service to the domain. And this enables us to start working with Active Directory for our SQL Server containers. The last step is we need to definitely create an MSSQL config file, which basically has the configuration details about the SQL Server that you're running. And the other file that we need to create is called the kerb5.config, which is the Kerberos configuration file that you need to create, which has the contents about what the domain is, where the KDC server is, where the domain controller is, and all of those details. So once you have these five steps ready, all you have to do now is go ahead and deploy your SQL Server containers with all these files. And that's it. And your SQL Server is ready and configured for Active Directory. So simple five-step process that we kind of have to follow.
Wow, cool. I mean, this is really interesting. I had, you know, I wasn't sure what the process would be, but it seems like it's fairly straightforward. And it also seems like Adutil is making it a lot easier. And maybe that explains how you're going to do this in less than 5 minutes.
Yes, and that's where, you know, let's set our stop clock and let's get started, and let's see if we can all achieve this in less than 5 minutes. So let's get to the demo here. So here I have an Ubuntu box, which is already part of a domain. So let me just show you that I'm already joined to a domain. Oops, so wrong command, it's realm list. So I'm already part of the domain, as you can see. The domain name that I have is a very real domain. It's called contoso.com. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my SQL Server container deployed. And this SQL Server container is going to be connected to this domain, contoso.domain. And we are going to have a user from Contoso log in to the SQL Server using Active Directory credentials in the next 5 minutes. Great. So what I've done is I've already created the MSSQL config file and the Kerberos config file. So let me just go ahead and show you what the file currently has. So as you would know, the Kerb5 has the Kerberos credentials. Basically, this file basically contains the domain names and the details about where my KDC is and what my admin server is. And what I'm also going to do is I've already created the configuration file for SQL Server as well. And as you can see here, what I have is I've enabled the privileged AD account that is SQL user. Now, the name says privileged AD account, but this is just a normal domain account, which is already created in the Active Directory, Windows Active Directory. And I'll show you the step that is taken to create it. And I've also pointed where my Kerberos keytab file is going to be inside the container. So the path that you actually see here, the where opt MSSQL secrets, this is actually inside the container. Now, all my files that I'm going to mount is going to be created under this directory that you see, which is container SQL container. So this is where all my files are going to get created. And I've already created a secrets folder. And inside this folder is where I'm going to create the keytab file. So with all of this cleared out, I think now it's a time for us to look at what Adutil can do for us. So the first thing that I wanted to show you is how you can go ahead and create an Adutil, how you could create a user using the Adutil command. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to show you the command. So this is the command that we basically use. We just say Adutil user create name, name of the user, the distinguished username with the domain and OU details, and the password. Of course, you would not want to pass the password like this. You don't have to type it out. In fact, you can give it in an interactive mode, which is much more secure. So I've already done this, and the user is already created in my Active Directory. So I'm not going to run this command. And then what I do is I need to create the SPNs for it. And the command now to create the SPN is basically adutil SPN. And here you can see, I basically am going to go ahead and create an SPN for the user SQL user, the service, which is MSSQL SVC, because this is for SQL. And this is going to be my container name. The Ubu SQL container one is what you're looking at, is going to be the name of my container. And contoso.com and the port on the host that this container is going to listen for connections is going to be 5434. I've already done this, and to just show you the SPNs that I already have, let me just run this command. And as you can see, here is the container name, the Ubuntu SQL container. This is going to be my container name. I've already registered here the port numbers to it. And here, let me just do a quick correction. When I created when I ran the adutil SPN, it was for Ubu SQL container, not container one. This was an older command. So I ran it for SQL container, and that's why you see SQL container over here. So I think I should have that also in the history just for our reference. There you go. This is the command which I basically ran to create the SPNs. As you can see here, it's actually Ubu SQL container. And that's why when I look at all the SPNs, you'll actually see the container details here. So now we've done two steps here. We've created the user, we've created the SPNs, and now it's time for us to create the keytabs. And that's what I'm going to do live here. So let me go ahead and go to the next command. So to create the keytab, the first command that I'm actually going to run is adutil keytab create. I'm going to give the location where I want my keytab to be created. That's the path that I give you, minus k. And then the user to which I want this container to be this keytab to be linked, and the password for that user, which is the same one which we used while creating. So when I hit enter here, it's basically going to ask me what is the encryption mode that you would want to select. I can go ahead and select one or multiple of them. So I'm going to go ahead and select the first encryption, which is AES 256. And I'm also going to select RC4. Again, RC4 is not recommended for production, but this is test, so I'm just using it. So I'm going to have two encryption modes created here. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add another entry inside the same key tab, which is going to be for the container name. and the SPNs that we created. So as you can see here, let me just zoom out of it. So you can see the entire command. It's going to be, this is going to be the command, the port number, the container name, and the password, and the service. So if I run this, it's going to ask me, do you want me to add the SPNs to the key tab? Yes, I do. And then I need to select the same encryption types that I selected for the first one. And once I do this, I can just do a K list of the entries that I have inside my key tab. And this should show me all the encryption types and the entries that I have. So this way, I know my key tab is created. So now I have my key tab created. I have the user created. I have the SPNs created. I have linked or I have configured the MS SQL config with the name of the user and also where the path for the key tab is. So all I have got to do now is just deploy my SQL Server container. And to do that, what I'm going to do first is let me just check. I don't have a previous deployment with the same name. There you go. I don't have one. And let me just go ahead and give permissions to this key tab we just created. I'm just giving read permissions. So this way, when I just take a look at the key tab, you would see that I just have the read permissions on the key tab over here. So this is what is necessary. So now we are all set. So I can just zoom out of this and clear the screen here for everybody. And here I have all the things ready. So now it's time for me to run my command to create the Docker. So here is the command to deploy the SQL Server container. And as you can see in this, I'm basically using the port 5434 on the host, mapping it to 1433, which you know is the port for my SQL Server service, the name of my container. And I, because this is an Azure VM, I need to provide these entries here that you see, which is which domain am I going to connect, what is the IP address of my domain, and some of these parameters. These parameters are only required when you are running it on an Azure VM because your network needs to route to the right domain and all of those. So that is why we add these. So once I do this, it's going to go ahead and start the Docker. And if the demo gods are with me, you should see the Docker started. Yes, it is. And now what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and try creating an account here. So let me just zoom in here. Oh, the zoom in doesn't work. So let me just see if I can connect to this SQL Server. So here I've just given the complete FQDN followed by the port number for SQL Server. And I should hit the connect to it. Here goes my strong password. There we go. I'll just go ahead. And I'm just going to go ahead and create this user, which is, again, as you can see, Anna, this is from the Contoso domain. So I'm just going to go ahead and execute this. There you go. And here we go and try the authentication with the same account that we just created. And bingo, there we go. So Active Directory authentication configured, and hopefully I was within the time limit of 5 minutes. And we have now AD configured for SQL Server container that's currently running.
Awesome. Wow, Amit, that was really cool. That was a lot of steps that you went through very quickly. I got to be honest, though, I think it might have taken you a little bit longer than 5 minutes, but you did explain everything, which typically you wouldn't have to do if you were setting this up yourself.
Yes. So, in fact, that's the same reason why we've created a complete documentation giving all of these steps with details and with syntax details in our documentation, which I'll be more than happy to share here as a link for our customers and for our viewers to take a look at.
Awesome. Thanks, Amit. Yeah, it's great to know that this is all documented. So if we forget a step, you know, we can go read more about it. And we'll include that in the description for this video. Amit, you know, thanks so much for joining us today. This was really cool. I learned a lot. I'm sure our viewers learned a lot. And if you like this video as a viewer, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and leave us a comment and let us know what you think of Adutil. Thanks again, Amit, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.
Sure. Thank you.